Aneeshwar, and I'm 7 years old, and the beauty of the planet inspired me the most. All these advancements in technology and science have made a drastic change to the human lives. But is it just the human race we care about? Aren't there many more creatures to look out? The pangolins and the African rhinos are being hunted for medicines, you might know. I'm here today to talk to you on behalf of our planet. Yes, our only planet, which has inspired all of us to do our wondrous innovations. But it's sick due to the toxic emissions. All those forests, woodlands and ponds were home for squirrels and birds making bonds. But all of that disappeared in a flip in huge buildings and factories. We must rethink. The camels straying across the desert, the peregrine falcons gliding across the prairies, the sea lions swimming gracefully in the oceans, and the thresher sharks feasting off the whipped off fish. We won't be able to see these glorious glimpses if we keep hurting the planet and its creatures. We must preserve the biodiversity by making small, meaningful changes around where we live, where we work, and where we go. Simple routines like spending time in nature, observing the wildlife, and understanding their needs can help. Making a small flower meadow can attract lots of bees. Making a small pond can give home to lots of wildlife, like damselflies and insects, what can attract lots of birds. We have created incredible machines and amazing constructions. I'm sure if we all work together, we can make this a better place. Not just for us, but for all of the animals. From the mighty blue whale to the tiny little ant, I want to remind this to you all. We're dependent on the nature for everything, and the nature just needs our care to stay healthy. I have a request for you all. Whatever project you take up, big or small, please keep the planet in mind, because we can't revive the planet if it's too late. Signing off, Aneeshwar Kunchala.